as some of the conditions encountered by KNON, the continuing crusade to bring critical information to remote Western Alaska. The KNON staff donated more than $8,000 to community outreach, including EMT ambulance due to food banks and a variety of community events. When seasonal upswings and abuse and suicide affect the area, KNON grabs listeners' attention with its annual Sled Dog Race coverage. They focus on the day-to-day drama that unfolds across the thousand-mile course, coverage that's credited with helping reduce seasonal depression and suicide in one of the country's poorest areas. Congratulations, and thank you, KNON, Nome, Alaska.
Thank you so much. It's an honor to be recognized by NAB. Thank you to the great staff at NAB, John David, Malik, and everyone for all they do for all our broadcasters. We wouldn't be here without our wonderful listeners who we thank every single day. Thank you to our board of directors and all the KNON supporters, including Tom, John, Jack, Ken, Patty, Frank, Les, Roland, and Bruce. Congratulations to our staff, Kelly, Lorelei, David, Laura, Lynette, and Betsy, and to the KNON volunteers who are running the station back in Nome right now, Ben, Matt, Maddie, Rebecca, and all our community volunteers. KNON serves Western Alaska, and we live far away in a corner of the world. In wintertime, we may be hard to reach without an icebreaker. But no matter what the challenges, there still is no place like Nome. Thank you very much.
Next, award goes to WKRQ-FM, Cincinnati, Ohio.
Listeners of the Cincinnati area. Events like Q102's Bosom Ball and Bras Across the Bridge helped raise $2 million for the fight against breast cancer, and part of nearly $4.5 million in cash raised for charities in 2011. The station's Rally for Relief events sent trailer truckloads of food, clothing, and emergency supplies to tornado victims in Missouri and Alabama. Q102's Little Red Breast Party brought women together on Valentine's Day to raise funds for the American Heart Association. And the station's Heart Mini Marathon and Walk drew more than 18,000 runners. Congratulations and thank you, WKRQ Cincinnati.
I keep getting during lunch, which is so rude to be sitting there. Not yet. Nothing yet. Nothing new. Before we came in here, I was speaking to someone from KRZG in Joplin, Missouri. You know, he looked at me and he said, you know, I love getting the nomination, but it is what we do. And when I take this home, as proud as everybody will be, that is the truth. With or without the nomination, I wouldn't change a thing. It's what we do. I'm thankful to work for a company that supports this, doesn't demand it, but challenges us to step up and make a difference. And at the end of the day, Joplin, Missouri, Cincinnati sent you a Mack truck full of supplies when you need it. I expect you'll do the same for us if we do. Thank you, Jenny, Bruce, Drew, Greg, my local support, Mike Frederick and Jim Bryan, who challenged me in so many ways, and to support me in all the important ones. I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Okay. Our next Crystal Radio Award goes to KNDE-FM, College Station, Texas.
There's a lot of talk today about where people turn when they want music, but there's no doubt about where they turn when they need help. They turn to radio. And KNDE and College Station is a great example of that. Their Candy Cares for Kids Radiothon generated $135,000 for pediatric care at a local hospital. The Christmas Angels Project collected warm clothes and more than 2,000 new toys for 500 needy children. Working with the Junior school supplies for children whose families couldn't afford them. And when an EF5 tornado devastated portions of Joplin, Missouri, KNDE staff led a 16-hour supply collection and then led the way in driving 3 trailer loads of aid to the tornado victims. Congratulations and thank you, KNDE, College Station, Texas.
KNDE stands for Candy 95, which Ken Downs, their general manager, chose that name when we put the station on the air about 10 years ago. We are the home of Texas A&M University, and as such, we learned a long time ago that it's very important that it's in our DNA to serve our community and to provide public service and localism to that community. So this may not be important to you people here, over here, over here, over here, but I can assure you it's very important what this represents to the community of Bryan College Station, Texas, Texas A&M University. Ben Downs, our general manager, the 50 employees that work very hard at Bryan Broadcasting, and the entire community of College Station in Bryan, Texas. Thank you very much for this honor.
Congratulations to our next winner, WSOYAM in Decatur, Illinois.
For nearly 9 decades, WSOY has been unprecedented community service and local action in Decatur, Illinois. But even measured against that tradition, 2011 was an extraordinary year. WSOY's 10th annual community food drive raised a record 640,000 pounds of food